Westminster Abbey, the Queen, whose father had flown with the fledgling RAF in 1918, joined her family and the RAF family to remember those who'd served in the air and on the ground.
I remember today my grandmother's brother, John, killed in a Wellington bomber in 1943. My grandfather's brother, Charles Corbell, was commanding the Royal Air Force for much of that war. And my father, I read his log book again last week. How right and proper that we should each remember all who served.
But this was also a day to celebrate the present. As the crowds joined the men and women of the 21st century RAF, parading in colours outside Buckingham Palace, the Queen spoke of her own links with the service. From the First World War to space. Its motto, through adversity to the stars, lies at the heart of this spectacular birthday. Robert Hall, BBC News. That was the women's quarterfinal at Wimbledon today, and Serena Williams survived a bit of a challenge to make it into the semi-final. Jill Wilson tells us.
This honours board some of the players who made Wimbledon, who made modern tennis. This year's women's champion, there's a space, waiting for a story. It could still be the great Serena comeback. Williams was truly stretched today by Camilla Giorgi of Italy, three fierce sets. But Serena was up to it, a seeding 25 in September. Power? Reaching a Wimbledon semi-final is almost unimaginable territory for Germany's Julia Gergis, another winner today. And Yelena Ostapenko becomes the first Latvian woman to reach a Wimbledon semifinal. Unpredictable is often good. None of the top 10 seeds were even in these quarterfinals, but the players we did see rose to the occasion. Daria Kazatkina is at the bottom of the screen, playing Angelique Kerber. Now there were breathless rallies to end this match. Kerber triumphed. She's earned over $20 million in her career. Billie Jean King pioneered for just this kind of thing. And the honours board may just have a space for Kerber. Joe Wilson, BBC News.
Lord Paddington, the former Conservative Foreign Secretary, has died at the age of 99. He was the last surviving member of the post-war government after Winston Churchill. Lord Paddington served as a tank commander in the Second World War, and his long ministerial career ended when he resigned at the time of the Argentine invasion of the Falkland Islands back in 1982. Our diplomatic correspondent, James Robbins, is back at his young life.
People looking for an example of a British politician resigning as a matter of honour often point to Lord Carrington. He was Foreign Secretary when Argentina invaded the Falkland Islands in 1982. Their forces simply walked into Port Stanley. Britain was unprepared, the foreigner